I want to preach on fatherhood and being a good father, because at the end of the day, fathers, you know, you may not be spending the most time with your children. You know, God has designed it where the men are going to be working and the women are going to be staying at home. Moms are going to be raising the children while dad's at home. But you know what? The responsibility ends with you. As the head of the household, the father is ultimately responsible for everything that happens within your house. There is no excuse beyond you. So if mom isn't raising the children right, guess what, dad? That's your problem to deal with. That's something you have to correct. You can't just blame your wife on your children growing up wrong. You need to fix that. That is your job. That is your responsibility. And God has given a lot of responsibility, we'll get into that a little bit later, on fathers. You know, when we talk about the different roles between women and men and you know, husbands and wives, the world wants to make it look like, oh man, it's great to be the man, and just the woman is just has this horrible job and she just has to cook and clean and raise kids and do all this stuff. It's like, what you don't understand is the level of responsibility that goes along with the leader, with the one that's in charge, with the one being the boss. Everything relies on the decisions that dad makes. So it's not just this great, glorious job. Hey, you're responsible. That's a big deal. I think it's kind of nice that God has allowed for the wife to not have that level of responsibility hanging over her head with everything else that she needs to do. That at the end of the day, though, dads, it ends with you. You need to make sure that your family is being run the way that you want it to be run. And there's no excuse. We're going to look at this example of Eli, and we're going to look at a few things that he did wrong and where we should be wary of not to have it happen to us. Because I believe Eli was saved. I believe he was a man of God, but he just totally failed at being a father, and his children went to the devil. So don't think that just because you bring your kids to church every week that they're going to grow up to be some great Christians. Don't think that just because you put them in and just expose them to preaching that it's automatically going to happen. Because it's not. Not necessarily. You need to be involved. Dads need to be involved in their children's life.